Hello viewers, this is Rajiv Bhoumik. You are watching my channel Make Things Easy. Welcome to my channel. You will get lot of useful videos in my channel. So please subscribe my channel and watch this video till the end. 5S is a Japanese concept. It consists of 5 words starts with S. The words are Sheri, Sheton, Shishu, Shiketsu, Shitsuke. The English meanings are Sheri means sort, Shiton means set in order, Shishu means shine, Shiketsu means standardize, Shitsuke means sustain. 5S started in Japan in 1990s as Toyota production system. Service industry started using 5S in 1990s. So it is almost 30-40 years 5S started. But still you will find so many companies, they are not able to maintain 5S. The basic reason is they have not understood or they have not maintained the basic things. So in my video, I have tried to give some input so that if somebody see my video, they will understand what are the basic minimum thing required to maintain 5S. This part of the video is very much important. Please see it properly. A organization, they want to implement 5S. First of all, they need to divide the factory into zone, as I have shown in the figure. After that, they need to select zone leader. After that, they need to do 5S review. For 5S review, they need to select 5S coordinator among the zone leaders, and head of the organization will work as 5S chairman. Now they need to do 5S training for all the employees. This video can be shown as training module. Then actual 5S to be done, which you will be watching next part of the video. Then audit to be done. One zonal head can go to other zone for auditing, and his zone can be audited by other zone leader. Periodic review to be done. In the periodic review, before after photo should be shown. Audit score will be there. There will be audit, there will be audit score. And if score is less, then corrective actions to be taken. And in every periodic audit, next audit date and next review date to be fixed. Let us start with 1S, that is sorting. Sorting is done by 12 steps. Step 1, we have to identify team members. We have already identified zone and zone leader. So there will be a team. Step 2, we have to gather all the articles like red tag, camera, pen, writing pad, etc. Step 3, we have to fix up a date when we are going to do the red tagging. Step 4, we have to fix up the area for red tagging. Step 5, two things need to be identified, the specific items to evaluate. Number 2, physical areas where red tagging will take place. Step 6, set your own criteria based on usefulness, frequency and quantity, or only keep what is required in the next 48 hours. Step 7, you have to take before photograph of that area of your zone. Step 8 is you have to do red tagging. Whatever material not required by you, you put red tag on this. Step 9 is evaluate the red tagging, and you have to note down in the logbook what are the things you have written, you have put red tag. Step 10 is dispose those red tag item to red tag area and also assign action on this. Step 11 is after removing the red tag item, you take photo of that area of your zone. Step 12 is update recognition board and congratulate the team for doing the red tagging. Points to be considered in red tagging activity. Tag must be responded too quickly, less than 1 week. Suppose you have put red tag on some item, so those items may not be required by you, but may be required for somebody else, some other department, or maybe for some other plant of your same company. So you need to give time to them, you need to inform them so that they can see whether they can use those items. Give all shifts and potential user a chance to respond to tag. Challenge yourself, look at all items very carefully before putting red tag. If items are defective, then eliminate. If it is excess, then send it to store. If obsolete, then dispose. Now I am giving you an example. Suppose you have a sweater. You are not using it always. So you will use it in winter only. So you have to keep it aside, maybe in almira. But you have a shirt. You are wearing it every day. So you need to keep it nearby you so that every day you can use it. Now let us see 2S, that is set in order. Arrange items so that they are easy to find and readily retrieved, a place for everything and everything in its place. Apply can see, can take out and can return philosophy. Now here see a photograph, a shadow board is there, some items are kept on the board. Mr. John is taking one hammer from that board and he is writing on the logbook that he has taken that hammer. Now Mr. Harry will come, he will not find that hammer on that board, but after seeing the logbook, he will understand that Mr. John has taken that hammer. Now here see a office drawer where 2S is maintained. Now here you can see a maintenance shadow board where all the maintenance tools are kept. Let us see some example of 2S. A customer is asking for item XX. Storekeeper found same item is available in his store, so immediately he responded to customer, yes, that item is available. Another example, a storekeeper found a box kept on the rack. The item number mentioned on the rack and the item number mentioned on the box is different, so immediately he has taken action. Another example, see two benches, one is very haphazard, another is very properly managed. See, there is a photo where pallets are kept in a haphazard way and the after photograph is very properly managed. See another example of 2S. The almira is very haphazard and after, the almira is properly identified and properly managed. Now let us see 3S. 3S is shining. Shining is nothing but cleaning. Cleaning of shop floor, cleaning of machine, cleaning of office, cleaning of desk, cleaning of office item, cleaning of anything. Points to be considered while cleaning: must be done on a regular basis. Determine what to clean, then assign specific individuals to task. Necessary cleaning tools and supplies to be available at usage point. Designate specific cleaning time, maybe last 5 minutes of a shift. Now cleaning means inspecting faulty parts, hidden broken gauge, loose nuts and bolts, cracked housing, lubricant levels. Now what is CLEAT chart? CLEAT chart is daily or weekly or monthly monitoring of cleaning, lubrication, inspection and tightening. Few examples of cleaning. See, people are cleaning. See, one thing we have to keep in mind, while cleaning we have to wear proper PPEs. Now 4S, that is standardize. Whatever 1S, 2S, 3S is done, that should be continued. And if any standardization is done in one machine, same thing to be continued in other machines. Example of standardized activities: SOPs, checklist, formats, color coding, symbols, etc. If you are a zone leader, you need to standardize a desired map of your workplace. That means where are the things should be kept, you should have a proper map and you have to keep those items in that place only. Few examples of 4S. See, this is a office file cabinet. If one file is missing, then the line will be disturbed. The shop floor, you can see the gangway is very clear. Materials are kept in their place. In the store, a forklift is kept in its proper place. Now let us see 5S, that is sustain. We have done sorting, that is 1S. we have done set-in order, that is 2S, we have done signing, that is 3S, we have done standardized, that is 4S. Now we have to maintain all these 4 again and again. Then 5th S, that is sustain, will be maintained. So this is the methodology of sustain. In the beginning of the video, we have discussed that there will be audit. So this is a audit sheet for 5S and safety together. So there will be some scoring, like 0 for very bad, 1 for bad, 2 for okay, 3 for good, 4 for everything okay. So like this, you have to score each area for 5S and safety. After audit, you have to give mark for all the 10 points, and in an Excel sheet, automatically it will be calculated and a radar sheet will generate. In any area, if the score is less, then you need to take corrective actions. Let us see few examples of sustain activity: evaluation, recognition, further improvement, refresher training, progress report, awarding, etc. Benefits of 5S. Now see here, there is a before 5S photograph, which is haphazard, and the after 5S photograph is very nice. Things are kept properly. 5S can be applied in factory, hospital, bank, office, shop, store, godown, school, even at our home. Through 5S, we can get less wastage, improved efficiency, better space utilization, improved maintenance, because through CLEAT, most of the maintenance job will be done, improved safety, better and more committed employees, improved quality. Ultimately, neatness and cleanliness will lift the image of the organization. So viewers, thanks for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and like this video, share this video. And if you want to comment some things, please leave your comment in the comment section. Thank you once again for watching this video.